Namaskar, welcome to Asia News India, myself Poonam.
In an alarming incident that sheds light on the dark reality of labor exploitation, Asia News received a desperate plea for help from a mother in Tulpana, Ranchi. Her son Roshan, a 16-year-old boy who had recently completed his 10th grade examination, had been ruled to Bengaluru with the promise of work but found himself trapped in a dire situation. On the night of June 18, 2024, at around 10:43 p.m., our phone's lines rang with a frantic call from a mother residing in Tulpana, Ranchi. Her voice thick with worry and despair, she pleaded with us to help rescue her son Roshan. Roshan, a bright young man who had just finished his 10th grade exams and was eager to contribute to the family income, had been enticed by a cunning individual named Marconi. Marconi had painted a rosy picture of a well-paying job opportunity in Bengaluru. Preying on Roshan's inexperience and desire to prove himself, however, upon reaching their promised location, Roshan's dreams were quickly shattered. Marconi's true colors emerged, and Roshan found himself trapped in a nightmare situation. When Roshan rightfully demanded the wages he had been promised, Marconi refused to pay. To silence Roshan's pleas and intimidate him into submission, Marconi resorted to brutal violence. In a seeking display of cruelty, Marconi slashed Roshan's finger with a sharp knife and beat him mercilessly with a thick stick. Roshan, traumatized and physically wounded, felt utterly helpless and alone. Roshan also mentioned that his brother were lured by the same men and had already escaped and were in the trains back to home. Roshan also mentioned that Marconi's brother and Marconi had severally beaten a man that worked with Roshan and disfigured his body and left him to die. Roshan was understandably distraught and shaken, managed to contact us. Through a video call, he shared his ordeal, his voice trembling as he narrated the horrific events that had unfolded. He showed us the injuries inflicted by Marconi. A painful slash across his finger and bruises on his body. Stark evidence of the abuse he had endured, disoriented and filled with fear. Roshan was unsure of his exact location. He believed he was in Bengaluru. But thanks to his presence of mind, he was able to utilize his digital literacy to his advantage. Using his phone's location sharing feature, he sent his live location via WhatsApp, a beacon of hope that would ultimately lead to his rescue. Understanding the urgency of the situation, we immediately transferred ₹500 to Roshan's account through UPI. This small amount of money could help him with immediate necessities, such as food and transportation. As he planned his escape, we instructed Roshan to find a safe haven like a police station or public place with security personnel and to stay there until help arrived. We also advised him to converse his phone battery and to keep his phone switched on so that we could maintain communication and track his movements. However, by 1 a.m., Roshan's phone switched off and his location could not be traced anymore. We contacted the Tamil Nadu police and despite initial language barriers, we were able to connect with the DSP Uday Kumar Singh of Krishnanagari. The police response was swift and commendable, especially considering the late hour. With the assistance and using the information from Roshan's last known location, we were able to pinpoint the building where he was being held captive. Acting with commendable urgency, a team comprised of officers from the Hauser Camp Police, led by DSP Hauser and Hauser Camp, rushed to the building identified through the location data. The information provided by us was crucial, as it allowed the police to narrow down their search and locate the exact building within the Mornapalli area of Hauser. Time was of the essence, as there were a highly probability that Roshan could be in further danger. The police team surrounded the building, prepared to apprehend the culprits and ensure Roshan's safety. Upon entering the building, they found Roshan bound and in a state of terror. The sight of police officer bursting through the door must have been a surreal and overwhelming experience for Roshan. Relief likely washed over him, he realized that his ordeal was finally coming to an end. The officer immediately moved to secure Roshan and surrounding area. They checked for any other victims and ensured that there were no immediate threats. Roshan, weak and shaken, was unable to provide a detailed account of his captivity. But the officers were able to gather enough information to piece together the events that had led to his rescue. The sudden arrival of the police startled Marconi and his accomplices, who fled the scene in a desperate attempt to evade capture. The police successfully rescued Roshan, bringing an end to his ordeal. Roshan was rescued and has since been safely returned to his home in Tulpana. This incident serves as a stark reminder of the vulnerabilities faced by young and often desperate job seekers. It also highlights the crucial role that media and law enforcement can play in combating such exploitation. The escape of Marconi and his gang has raised serious concerns about their possible involvement in a larger human trafficking network. The lure of gainful employment is a common tactic used by traffickers to prey on vulnerable individuals like Roshan. The swift action of the police has not only saved Roshan from further harm but has also potentially disrupted a wider criminal operation. Investigations are ongoing to uncover the full extent of Marconi's activities and to bring all those involved in the heinous crime to justice. Asia News team remains committed to exposing such injustices and ensuring the safety and well-being of those who fall victim to them. We applaud the Tamil Nadu police for their prompt and effective action in the case and hope that this incident will serve as a catalyst for greater vigilance and stricter measures to prevent such exploitation in the future.
For more updates, keep watching Asia News India.